Hey you guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Z. Welcome to the channel. Welcome back if you are a returning subscriber. So if you are a returning subscriber, you guys, you can tell by the name change. So basically I just switched up the name of the channel. So now it's called Pink Orb Intuitive Readings and Spiritual Guidance. I just wanted to, you know, throw that out there just so you guys know that it's still me. We still here. So if you're new here, make sure you go ahead and subscribe, hit the notification bell as well to be notified for new uploads. So yeah, let's get into the read. This is going to be a general love read for Geminis. Keep in mind, it's very general. It may not apply to everyone. That's totally fine if it is not. If you do want more accuracy, you can book a personal read with me. It's done in video format. So basically, it's just an unlisted YouTube video that will be sent to your email. So you can check the description box below for my information on how to do so. It's super simple to do. You just click on book a reading. We'll click the Linktree link. Click on book a reading, submit your info. I will respond back to you. So let's see what's going on here with Geminis. What messages do you have for Geminis? I'm gonna say for December, y'all, but this could have already happened for someone. It could be currently going on. Usually it'd be like currently going on for some people, or it could happen for someone at a later date. But sometimes past energy does show up in the read as well. So just keep that in mind. What messages do you have for Geminis for December? Okay, so Gemini, look, y'all got two cards that showed up here. And now, the cards I'm about to show y'all, it could seem kind of contradicting y'all, but just bear with me, okay? Because the first card that showed up here is pay attention to the red flags. The signs are cautioning you. Gemini, you guys are looking at new love, but like you think that it has red flags. For some of y'all, you just need to just watch out for any type of red flags that you could have. Like if you are wanting new love and you know you are attracting that energy as well, try to keep an open mind, because like you could be thinking that everybody got red flags, Gemini, but that's not the case, okay? So it is saying too that it is safe for you to love. So I feel like overall spirit saying, Gemini, yes, it is safe for you to love. Like it is okay for you to open your heart to give and receive the highest energy of all, which is love, you guys. But also too, like don't be crazy now, peep the red flags, okay? So yeah, I feel like that's what it's saying so far, but let's get one more card, Gemini. Give me one more for Gemini. Thank you. So yeah, okay, y'all, look, we got trust that showed up here. Look, I got Gemini in my chart too, so I'm trying to see something real quick. We got trust that showed up here. So it says this situation is calling for you to have faith, Gemini. For some of y'all, you're just needing to have faith in regards to new love. Like, don't, I feel like, Gemini, you could definitely be thinking like everybody out here got red flags, like you don't want it, like no, it's not for me. But we got true love that showed up here at the bottom of the deck too. There's like a lot of flirty energy surrounding you guys. But it says this is the romance of a lifetime. It looks like here you guys could definitely be kind of like, you could definitely have your options open, you guys. But I do feel like a lot of people are flirting with you, Gemini. Or you could be flirting with a lot of people too. But I feel like it's almost like this energy is coming towards you, Gemini. And you looking like, no. Like y'all got red flags. Like I don't want it. But it's saying like, hey, just try to keep an open mind about new love, or like people that could be like kind of coming at you in a very flirty way. So let's see. I'm gonna use my love oracle deck. If you're new here, I created a love oracle deck, so I'm gonna clarify each card, y'all. It's about to get a little juicy, so just hold on real quick, okay? Let's start off with pay attention to the red flags. Yeah, you've been hurt, Gemini, and look, you think everybody got red flags, y'all, but with this trauma card, y'all, I put you'll be all right, okay? It's like even though you're going through like a little heartache, pain, like you still alive, your heart's still beating, okay? It's gonna be okay. And I do feel like, too, like, Gemini, you got the sage, okay? Look, y'all burning the sage on people, you like, people got red flags. Sage you off of me was right here, too, so hold on. Clarify, it is safe for you to love for Gemini. Look, tell me why sage you offer me showed up, y'all. Look, yeah, you don't trust nobody, Gemini. You staging people off of you. But let's get one more because I had already showed y'all that card, but I'm trying to see what else shows up. Clarify it and say for you to love for Gemini. And I do feel like what I just got, y'all, intuitively, Gemini, for some of y'all, you could be like very I don't want to use the word like superstitious, but I feel like someone's like very spiritual and you thinking about y'all. This is too funny, but nah, it's kind of low-key resonate with me in a sense, because I'm a Gemini rising. It's like you could be very superstitious, or it's like you, when you think about new love or like new people coming in, y'all, like you thinking about some other stuff. It's like the spiritual side of things, like you just thinking like this person has red flags. Are you thinking that they could be like, you know, the toxic one, that type of thing? Like you thinking like it's not true love, that type of thing. Like you're just scared that you're gonna end up with like a dub, or you know, you're gonna take a ill if you open up your heart, basically. That's what it feel like. Clarify trust. I couldn't really explain it, y'all, because like what I was thinking in my head, it couldn't come out. But anyway, clarify trust for Gemini. Clarify trust. Yeah, for some of y'all, you could definitely be kind of like, you think that you could be dealing with a person, y'all, they just want something casual, like they don't want anything serious. I feel like this is someone's like mindset, y'all, but it's saying to keep an open mind, because I feel like maybe you dealt with some people here where it's like you kind of gave them the benefit of the doubt, or you could have just given them a chance, y'all, and they had red flags that you may have not been aware of. It's like you wasn't really sure if that was a red flag or not. But now it's saying like, Gemini, you already know what red flags to look for as well. So it's like you already know what you about to get into, or like you already know how to like spot out any type of red flags that or any type of signs as to where you feel like the person's going to hurt you. So just pay attention to the people's like actions, and also to it's like their demeanor, like how they come off, how they communicate as well, y'all, because like sometimes people show you, like, I don't know, for me, y'all, I can tell right off if a person got red flags, y'all, like from like a slight conversation. It don't even have to be like, it can be something so simple, like, so I don't know if y'all like that too, but you just already know that y'all not about to move forward with nothing, okay? Like, you don't want nothing serious with the person. So let's see what shows up here. I think I'm gonna use this other deck. Hold on, y'all, let's see. All right, so let's see what pay attention to the red flags is, or what it could be for someone. So whenever this card shows up in like a love read, y'all, whether it be like a general read for like YouTube or a personal read, I'm gonna ask, what is the red flag? So we just about to get straight to the point. What is the red flag here for Gemini? What's the red flag for Gemini? What's the red flag for Gemini? I'm gonna ask one more time. Tell me about the red flags here for Gemini. What's the red flag? Oh. This is about the red flag here for some of you guys. This is about someone opening up. It's like in regards to like your heart, basically. So, because we got it to say for you to love, and it says open your heart, but you know, trauma is here. So it's like the heart is not in a good state to be opening up. The heart healing. Okay, Gemini, so for some of you guys, you could definitely be, now either you are another person that you could be dealing with, they're hurt, so this could definitely be a red flag as to, like, kind of like why they're not opening up, like, someone's not making, and also, too, some of you guys are in a connection here where it's kind of hard for someone to make a decision in regards to commitment, and also, too, it's like going into a new direction, like, finally making a decision here. Use your intuition as well about whoever this is that's like not really opening up as well. I'm gonna ask one more time. What's the actually, hold on, y'all. Clarify, pay attention to the red flags here for Gemini. Oh, okay. So it does look like here, Gemini, this is something real for some of y'all, but either you or the other person, Gemini, is playing games. So it's like maybe something's not really like official. Somebody playing games, and I do feel like too, there's a sense of somebody not really speaking their truth too. They could just be afraid to be hurt. Usually that's what it is. But let's see. And I don't know why it looks like here, from what the cards are showing y'all, it's almost like somebody needs to like sage their heart. Like, that's crazy, ain't it? But that's the way it's showing up here to me. Clarify, it is safe for you to love. Yeah, this is your 10 of cups, Gemini. You're needing to just have faith here in regards to this situation here, y'all. Somebody is dealing with like an Empress type of energy. You could be dealing with a Aries here, a fire sign. So it could be like an Empress type of energy, but I just see like a fire sign energy that's showing up here. Tell me more about it is safe for you to love for Gemini. Yeah, look, we got the star card that showed up here, you guys. So look, overall, it's saying that Gemini, this is your 10 of cups. But you need to have faith that if you move forward, that like you're going to be moving on to calmer waters. Like, look, there's somebody here who's guiding you as well. Like your guides or spirit team, whatever you want to call it, they got you. They're going to protect you. Okay. So let's see. Tell me about trust here for Gemini. Yeah, for some of y'all, you think that this situation is nothing serious. But like I said, pay attention to the person's like demeanor, how they talk, their communication, how they handle you as well. Tell me about trust here for Gemini. Okay, I got it's a water sign right here, y'all. It's the masculine energy. So some of you guys could be dealing with the Cancer, Pisces, or a Scorpio here as well. But we got the King of Cups that showed up here. Also, too, the King of Cups is like a person here who they're like trustworthy as well. So if they feel some type of way, y'all, they're gonna let you know. The King of Cups. Tell me about trust. They're really mature as well in regards to like their emotions. For some of y'all, you're afraid to be left out on the cold. We got the Moon card that showed up here. Use your intuition here as well. I do feel like for some of y'all, you're getting dreams about the situation. It's almost like the only way you'll know if this is okay to open your heart is from your dreams, honestly. It's like that's the only way spirit can get through your head. Like, with the Moon card showing up here, yeah, some of you guys are afraid that you're going to get left out in the cold and that you have, because you've been dealing with a lot of messy stuff. You probably was dealing with some sneaky links or something that, you know, they didn't want nothing serious or they were, like, unsure about you. Give me one more here for trust for Gemini. Give me one more for trust for Gemini, please. Give me one more. Clarify trust for Gemini. Wow, so we got the Queen of Wands. Some of y'all are needing to take action here towards, like, just get confident here in regards to, because I feel like I'm talking to, like, a female Gemini, but, I mean, don't say the gender series. I'm just going based off how I feel. But, yeah, with the Queen of Wands showing up here, some of you guys are definitely need to, like, don't sleep on yourself when it comes towards, like, new love or, like, you know, a new partnership. Because the Queen, not the Queen of Wands, like, she don't sleep on herself. She takes action. She's, like, very assertive. She's confident. Also, too, like, she's comfortable in her own skin as well. And we got the Empress showing up here, too. This is definitely some type of new beginning here. But it's like you guys are needing to take action towards this situation. That's what it's showing. But you think that it's a red flag. But let's pull some additional oracle cards here. Give me one here for Gemini for their love spread. Okay, so we got within it. Okay, so we got two timing cards, y'all. Sometimes it'd be hard to get a timing card, but look, within the next few months showed up here, but within the next few weeks popped out at the bottom of the deck. Some of you guys could be about to meet somebody new. It's like new love is definitely coming in. So it's like, I'm assuming like the top, you know, next year sometime for somebody. But it looks like Gemini for some of you guys. Now, it could be you or the person that you could be dealing with, y'all. It's like someone needs to go ahead and make a decision about heading into a new direction. But it's like just having faith here, too, in regards to opening up to another person. Like, basically, you having clarity on whether or not it's really, really safe for you to open your heart, okay? Give me another one here for Gemini for their love spread, please. Look, it says you're ready, y'all. Oh my God. You're ready to head into a new direction. Some of you guys could be dealing with someone else because we got there something better that showed up. Some of you guys could definitely need to make a decision here. Now, it could be like a third party type of situation, y'all. But it's like whoever has the red flags, like, you'll know if things are just not okay between you and another individual that you're dealing with. Like, it's saying just go ahead and, like, pay attention to those red flags here. This person could have hurt you as well, but it looks like you're needing to, like, move, like, go into a new direction. There's new love in store for you. You're just needing to trust that you are ready. Like, trust yourself. And then there's something better. Yeah, so look, tell me why I moved. There's something better, and listen to your intuition. So, yeah, it just confirmed what I was talking about. Listen to your intuition here about, you know, an individual that you could be dealing with here, because there's something better, but you just have to make that decision. Like, you have to make that move towards heading into a new direction. And release any worry, fears, or self-doubt that you could have about starting over or, like, starting new as well. So, yeah, I'm going to leave the read here. I hope that was helpful to you guys. Of course, you can leave a comment below. Give the video a thumbs up if you did take some type of information or insight from the read. If you're new here, feel free to subscribe as well. And make sure you hit the notification bell to be notified for new uploads.